And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Good fade. Good low fade, Lou.
We start calling out radio techniques.
Ooh, nice.
Ooh, good ramping. Oh, solid ramping. Did you just dump that? Oh.
Could you pop me up?
Oh.
pop me up.
Ooh, thanks for noticing.
Yeah.
It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, coming to you on a rainy... Well, now it's Thursday. Right now it's Tuesday. Because it's the Lost Tapes.
On a rainy Thursday.
Jay and I watched his favorite Cops clip of all time.
Favorite of all time.
Which is easily... That's an instant classic.
It's the best one ever. Yeah. It's the black guy...
New Orleans bar.
Yeah, New Orleans bar doing karate moves.
It's just... Not moves. He's just doing karate hands. Like, yeah. He's got the glow.
But he has a lot of it, and they just relentlessly pepper spray his face.
By the way, they don't get physically involved with him until the very end. Because they're just like... it looks like a squirt gun fight.
But the display he puts on.
And then he's like, well, he just keeps eating it, but then he's eating it like a guy that you could watch on his face that he's starting
to... It's wearing
to,
on him. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, but he's still doing the karate hands. He's like, I'm trying to breathe in. It's one of the best clips of all time. There it is. Yeah, we'll tweet it out at The Bonfire.
It's just so good.
At The Bonfire SXM on Twitter. Just eating.
It never stops making me laugh how much they never engage. They just keep whacking it with more pepper spray. Every karate movie does.
And then he keeps starts doing the face where you're running and your side hurts. So he's doing this face. He's like... Watch. He shakes it up.
He's cranking that can up.
He goes...
He picked up a glass now, and he's threatening.
But
pretty threatening with it. I don't know what he's going to do. Then he puts it down.
They grab it, and squirt gun fight. Squirt gun fight.
I mean...
Oh, dude, that door is, kicks open.
He looks like he jumped into a pool when he's done with pepper spray.
Yeah.
Standing
at
a sink. You turn us up. There's great audio here.
He's like,
where are you going to take me first?
Your knees.
Oh, he's just spraying.
Come on your knees now.
Come on. He's putting water on his face from a sink. He's in a bathroom.
What are you taking me to first? Now go.
On your knees.
Keeps trying to wash the pepper spray off his face, and then he puts on a display.
He says, put the bats down and I'll come in peace. So he offers him away without karate. This guy's shit in his pants.
Now he feels he has a second wind.
I thought you got set up. I thought the ambulance
was there. Uh-oh. Here it comes.
Come on.
You know what? Always respect for that guy, because he just fucking did it. He did the thing.
Yeah, rewind it, Christine. It gets like a clean audio on the noise that guy makes. It's the best thing ever.
Right here. Come on.
And then he just gets met with
17 cops.
He puts on a display, and then he eats 2 gallons of pepper spray directly in the face.
Dude, he just
he
goes
did not.
Full.
His glow got extinguished
pretty quick. In fact, they had too much pepper spray on him to get the glow. When you
reach
get the glow,
final level, your bomb body is so. Ow! Is that pepper spray?
He goes, when you get the glow, don't get pepper spray; it'll wear off.
The only thing with the glow is that it's not rack well pepper spray. You don't want to get the glow wet with the glow when the glow with
your
got
mind,
the glow.
Body, and eyes will burn.
Don't pour water on it. It's going to get on your body, and it burns there, too.
Dude, that was...
It's the best clip.
Come on!
It's the best... Yeah. Come on!
Spitting out nasty taste while you're getting the shit kicked out of you.
Oh, my God.
Tap.
And then, by the way, the calm after the storm on Cops is always just the best. He's like, can you get my left eye, please? It's still a little burning.
He goes, thanks.
Thank you. I know you guys have been mad respectful. I appreciate that.
Yeah, thanks for only squirting me with 6 cans.
That's got to be the worst for the cop, just dealing with the crazies.
Yeah. You guys.
You know what would really solve that guy's problems?
What?
Fucking rebar, homemade hatchet to the head.
Dude, Jay showed me a video of a guy making a rebar hatchet.
Well, someone sent it on the Facebook camper.
Jay pulled it up on the Facebook. I'm like a grandpa. Jay has to show me stuff online.
I don't know how your crazy machine works.
I don't like it. I like my tiny phone with my music, with my beats.
That's
and
the
my pops.
Family Guy who's trying to teach an old lady to use a computer. So, I don't want it.
Oh, the Italian mother yeah. technology?
I don't want it.
He was dirty, Ma!
Now I got no sons.
Yeah, that's
Ma!
Right. Yeah, it's the San Gennaro Festival. Is that? I probably said that wrong.
Trying to
say that wrong?
Fucking,
I got it?
The Festival of San Gennaro?
Yeah.
I told Vecchione I've been lovers with several of his women of the Italian descent.
San Gennaro?
Yeah.
Are you going to the San Gennaro? It's happening, right?
I don't know.
Isn't it currently happening?
Yeah, I think it happened last week.
We are so on brand. That's what cool people say when they're right about stuff.
I guess. We're so on brand right now. Is this it?
Yeah.
Feast of San Gennaro. Every child here has seen a relative murdered in a barber chair. Step right up. Teach an old Italian lady how to use an iPad.
Now, that sounds like fun. I'll give it a try. Hey, how are you? Look what I got for you.
What is it?
It's a tablet computer.
I don't want it.
But you don't even know what it is.
I don't want it.
But you can watch movies on it.
My eyes hurt.
I'm trying to do something nice here.
For the last time, I don't want it.
I bet you if Joey was giving it to you, you'd take it.
Don't you bring him into this. Joey was a good boy.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Joey was a good boy. You thought he was making $100,000 a year hauling lumber?
Don't you start with this.
He was dirty, Ma.
I can't hear this. I won't hear it. He was an angel.
Oh, that's right. Angel Joey. Great Joey. Perfect Joey.
I gotta go to the church.
Oh, yeah, sure. Light another candle. That'll bring him back.
You watch your tongue.
Admit it. You wish it was me in that car instead of him.
Just take your little TV and go.
It's an iPad, you dumb cow.
Oh, I guess I don't have any sons now.
Ma! I'm sorry, Ma! Ma! Ma!
That's me and you, buddy.
That's me. I never thought I'd be an Italian grandmother, but apparently I am.
How does it? Let me get my glasses.
Hang on. Where is?
What's the button I push?
Andy was a good boy.
What do I talk into?
My merc face, Andy.
What do I talk into this end?
So hard not to bring up the snitching. Did we talk about it on the live show?
Yeah, probably.
Black Lewis is emphatically shaking his head.
Black Lewis.
If I have anything to say, it's that we talked about it. LJ knows what's up. Well, this is the, we brought up the hatchet.
We did bring up the hatchet, yeah.
Because
I showed you on the computer, on my pocket computer.
On your hand computer.
I showed you a video that a guy on one of the Facebook campers group people put out a video of a guy making a hatchet.
Out of a piece of rebar.
It's
like folding it.
Awesome. And there is something to be said for a homemade piece. I know, Jacob, you're very brand loyal, but...
No, I mean, there are great knife makers, like famous ones that I'm really...
Famous
I think it's a
ones?
Great craft.
Really? Famous ones?
Well, I don't know any of them, but I'm saying I went to a knife making convention in Miami, Florida.
Really?
Like the international knife. You would have loved it. You two would have flipped.
Jacob, I wish you had a hooker problem.
Yeah. Dude, I love it, though. I like that he went to fucking...
The international knife makers... convention in Miami, Florida. I went.
I'm worried about Jacob. I feel like Jacob goes to movies alone.
We have like the handmade knives that they're only one of a kind.
But do they
would have loved it?
Do they have a fun group name like the Stabbers or like Blades?
Are you
like,
guys all Blades?
Yeah, Blades with a Z. What do you guys do?
We're all Sheaths.
Sheaths.
I'm not one of them. I just was there to admire.
Yeah, just to admire.
You make a lovely knife, sir.
Well,
thank you.
I got to tell you,
I haven't talked to my son in 7 years.
But
I've been looking at a lot of stuff.
Handmade machete there. Like you were looking for, and you.
Well, listen, the
one of a kind.
The campers have been putting out and sending to us all kinds of crazy, awesome shit.
I mean,
awesome shit. I was turned on by one of the campers to a company called Microtech that makes the automatic. Those are the switchblades. The switchblades they have—they're so powerful.
How powerful?
That I don't want one.
Why?
Because it scares me that you would do anything where you're just not thinking and kind of put it up against something. You push that button, you'll kill somebody.
Really?
It's fucking crazy how hard and sharp this thing comes out.
I like that our fucking radio show has turned into a QVC knife show. We have some of the best blades on the planet. And we are, you know that QVC blade slip, right?
Go to YouTube, slip. Christine. Look up Microtech switchblades.
That's my favorite.
Automatic knives.
That was like the first internet video for me. Katana slip. Type in on YouTube, QVC katana slip. It is the hardest I think I remember ever laughing, but that was when E-Bombs World would just put up those videos. And that's where he's knocking the samurai sword and he goes, the tip just got me. Right here.
On this one. And the nice thing about these practice katanas. Oh, that hurt. Oh, that hurt big time. A piece of that just, the tip just got me, Odell.
Odell.
Wait till you see Odell.
Oh, that got me good.
You all right?
A piece of that That's tip Odell. Just got me.
Right now, we may need emergency surgery in the studio.
That's my
What
favorite.
The fuck?
Dude, that...
By the way, it would be great if Odell came and just, like, armed the fucking whole display off the table now and just goes, get the shit out of here. Faulty.
He goes, now we're selling Odell's applesauce made in Odell's backyard. Folks, we may need emergency surgery in the studio. That used to make me laugh. I would say that to by myself on long drives. But anyways, back to the blades.
Bring up Microtech, Christine.
That's why I want you to buy the good stuff, because you're fighting a zombie. That's the last thing you need.
Oh, no. Microtech's no shit. I'm going to show you what Microtech makes, what they call...
against spring...
They call a machete. No, but this isn't... They make things that aren't.
Dude, look Box at these, cutter. Look cool.
At these. No, look how they come out, man. It's crazy.
For right now, I think they've...
Whoa, buddy!
So,
this right here is the switch.
Oh, by the way, they all have that's a glass cracker on the bottom.
Yep. Yeah. I have a knife called the Responder, and it has a glass breaker on it, like in case you got to save somebody in a car.
The pride you speak about. I love it. I like that you're very. I didn't know this was a source of happiness.
Can you give me five of your knives' names? You have the Responder. What else do you have?
The Buck Alpha, which I think you said you ordered, which you are going to love.
Did we order that, Christine? The Buck Alpha?
No, we didn't order anything.
Oh.
Oh, we ordered something, but you already know that if you're listening right now. If you listen this week, you already know we ordered something.
Yeah, Buck Alpha.
The Responder. I think I have the Woodsman.
Okay. These all sound like Tom Clancy novels.
I think it's all things he says when he holds the women's knives when they... Yeah. When he keeps them in his apartment.
Yeah.
It's the please don't leave.
Yes, it's the oh God, why are you doing this?
It's just a baby, it's cold outside.
It's the my parents don't have a lot of money. It's the my skin's not good. I don't have good skin.
That's the Responder.
Look at the Responder, Jacob. What are you trying to do, dude?
Well, wait, go back to Microtech.
That's not the one I have. Mine's much better.
Microtech makes a three. This isn't an automatic knife. They make others. They make what they call fixed knives also.
Yeah.
They have a three-blade twisting fucking machete. It's the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Let's bring it up.
This thing is sweet. It's
got sweet. It's not in this video at all.
It's going to be next in the line.
Buddy, this thing.
OTF knives.
This thing's game changer.
Dude, I'm telling you right now.
I found it, so it's Mayans.
I want some oak finishing. Oh, we already know. We're going to talk about what weapons you helped me find.
This is mine. That's badass. That's your tread grip handle.
That's your semi-automatic?
I like that grip. Let me see it.
It's a monster. Oh.
There it is. The Jag Commando. Dude, look at this motherfucker.
The Jag Commando.
Dude, this thing is serious as shit.
YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about
the Jag Commando.
Look at this. An innovative fixed blade knife from Microtech. The Jag Commando gets its name from an Austrian Armed Special Forces Operations Unit.
That's like an alien knife.
This knife, but I'm sure they appreciate the reference to them.
Dude, I want
it's,
that.
It's a pretty
so
unique,
bad.
It's pretty awesome.
Fascinating knife. It's got three sides, so it's kind of like a pyramid, and they all work their way up and taper into one point.
Jesus.
In addition, there's a series of drilled holes that all line up. It's pretty unique. You can see here in the close up.
Dude, it's so awesome. Jacob, what do you think?
I'll tell you what. I don't think it's practical for what... You're going to stab a zombie in the head, right? The knife, because of the way it's curved, I feel it's going to turn your hand and get you off your balance.
Oh, off balance, but I was also going to say goo up some brains.
Yeah, I mean, I think really it's like... I think that's the Jag Commando, I'd say, is for coming under the chin. You know how they get them under the chin to hit
but
the brain stem
But I really do think it's
going to
twist no matter what. Because
that doesn't
of the way
matter.
I'm
mind
worried
that twist.
For you.
Then if I twist like that, I pull him a little closer and I get to say something cool in his zombie fucking face before he dies.
God, you ugly motherfucker. You are one ugly son of a bitch.
Time to die.
Again.
Looks like you're out. Tag. You're it. Just Arnold zombie line. Hey, stop it.
Red light. Green light.
Yeah. You're decomposing all over my knife.
Ooh, look at that rose gold.
Yeah, that's more you, dude. You know me. I need a nice wooden handle. I need a nice fucking lacquered finish.
Dan likes grandpa tools.
Hell yeah, dude. I'm going
to trying to put a shed together. I'm trying to get out there and kill zombies, man.
You know what my prized weapon is, so don't act like I'm not flexing when it gets down to it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Can we show him that?
No, not yet. We're not blowing the load in the first 10 minutes
of the
show.
That's your one. Yeah, because really there's... Because
I got a politic to actually have it made.
I will say there's projectile, there's firearms involved in Dan's butt, which is sort of against the rules. We're putting together a close combat, but technically it's still a close combat. It's great.
Thank you.
It's great. No, I think I said this to you already. What you're going to talk about later is going to be the centerpiece of your whole set.
That's great. I like where we're going. I like where we're heading on this.
Why? Do you have an orientation for Girl Scouts next week?
No. Dude, what the fuck? Look at that. Look at you. Tell me that's a Girl Scout knife. I will buck you. I will fucking belly to throat, dude.
It's just unreal.
A Damascus steel hunting knife with staghorn handle.
It's just, it's ridiculous, Dan.
Can I tell you?
It looks silly.
You look silly, dude. You're going to look silly on the wrong end of that.
I'm offering you both.
You need a hoof at the end of your fucking knife, you idiot?
I would love it. I would like a horn if possible. We do a horn?
Buckhorn.
Like a buckhorn.
Your knife's also the shit. It is Dan. My time to speak.
Dan, let them know that the walkers are coming.
I'm offering you both because I can't transport them, but just picture it like coming over to a gun.
Mm-hmm.
A guy who's got a collection of guns in the hotel room.
Yeah.
You come over, test out on mine which ones you like.
Can I stab your bed with it and see what you
like? Not my bed.
No. You know what, Jacob? That was nice.
Yeah, you get a good feel.
He just comes in, there's feathers.
There's an assortment.
There's just feathers in his room. He goes, what did you do? I went downstairs to get my laundry. I go, I like this knife the best. His bed's all slashed up. I like this one.
This one's good. This one went through those springs like butter.
I go, that suit, you weren't holding on to those suits, dude. I took his sleeves off to see how sharp these
also,
are.
It's defeating the purpose, Jacob. Me and Dan are going to make... We're going to make as much informed decisions as we can on this show.
This is the episode.
Recorded over 2 days.
Where we...
And then me and Dan will be receiving an uncomfortable assortment of knives delivered here to SiriusXM Studios.
You're going
to
be on some sort of government watch list because the amount of plates we ordered.
Well, over the weekend, I sent you a link. You didn't respond.
Yeah, dude. I was with my...
It was my weekend.
I was with
my grandmother. Jacob, I was with my grandmother playing cards. Her knee hurts. Have some fucking respect.
She has water on her knee.
God damn it. And then I was with my friend who works for the 49ers, who you belittle every chance you get.
I had a machete link for you. I guess I did nothing for you.
That's probably more important than your stupid fucking coach friend.
I don't even like him anymore.
You had to watch football instead?
I was at the game.
Oh, that's going to help. Oh, he's going to... Yeah, exactly. What are we going
to
do?
I need stories to tell the children of the post.
What are we
going to
do with your friend in the bunker? He's going to fucking run us a play on how to go get out there and do whatever?
Yeah, it's called organizing.
No, we don't need to organize. We move straight ahead. These zombies don't need tactical plans around them.
Yes, they do.
When we get into our battles with other survivors... Then maybe.
Well, so you're just going to, just leave him in the bunker until we need him?
We'll kill his people and take him. And then we'll lure him in with you.
What?
Yeah.
What?
I'm not waiting for your fucking friend to get here from San Fran, Dan. We got to move, baby.
I'm sorry, he's
going to have a migration across the country.
I'm calling that I'm running Trips Right Z Friendship on, too.
How about this? Is this a good compromise?
Loyalty.
Dan, is this a good compromise?
Loyalty.
If he's in the East Coast, if he's in the Virginia and above... On the east?
Oh my god, do you think I'm fighting across the country to get to Mike?
That's what you were made it sound like.
No, I'm fighting to Colorado so we can get to a fresh water well and build our compound.
I'll do it in Colorado.
Thank you.
I'll do it in Colorado.
Thank you.
I'll go there.
Thank you.
I still need a winner.
Yeah.
KnifeCenter.com.
What?
Trying to find the Jacob's link. I want you to see these fantastic machetes.
Jacob's like the horny guy that keeps bringing back the sex. Where he's like,
cool.
No,
he goes,
oh yeah, no, I think we could probably get chicken and waffles later, anyways.
I fucked a chick at that bathroom once there.
Yeah.
What? Oh, I forgot. That's the other thing too. I'm getting a Bali knife. I've been watching Bali knives, butterfly knives.
Oh, okay.
They're called Bali knives.
Oh, sorry, sorry.
I don't even know that.
I've been reading a bunch about these things.
I love that.
The butterfly knife, but I watched some videos of people with skills on it. I'm going to learn it.
No, you're not.
Oh, buddy. I will look some of these fat idiots who learned it already.
Go to knives.
You don't have to be an athlete for
this. You want the machetes are under outdoor survival.
Fuck yeah, they are. Why don't we just buy up that whole fucking
section?
I'm
only looking at survival.
Jacob, how many knives do you have?
That's not
Christine, don't ask that question.
Yeah. Not on the air, Christine.
You don't want to know the answer.
Wait, what is this tactical nylon gear?
Hatchets and axes.
Backpacks.
Jay, we got to get that. We got to get a tactical pack.
Oh, a wallet. Good.
No, go back. There's a tactical pack. Go back.
It's right there. It's the gear slinger.
Nylon gear.
Yeah, but the other one looked better.
Do we need one of those, Jacob?
For the collection we're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're going to need a pack.
Yeah, let's get a pack. Let's start with packs. Yeah.
I want packs. I want hooks. I want sheaths. I want things that clip to my body.
Dude, can I say this? I've had my backpack for 14 years. I think I need a new backpack.
What? Yeah. A tactical one?
I think I need it. No, I need one. I need a civilian one. I mean, obviously, yeah, I'm going to get a tactical one because we're building our.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, that's what's going to be. That's our go bag.
Yeah. Perfect.
I'll be honest with you.
Oh, one strap, Jay.
That's a big deal to me.
I want two straps.
Oh, I almost want that now for real.
You want two straps.
No, I don't.
Balance the weight.
Balances the weight, dude.
Give you problems.
All right, well, I'm talking about airport survival right
there
now.
There we go. All that one, all the way to the left. It's the 700, the black one. Yeah. Hell yeah. Look at that. Hydration pack?
Wow, yeah, that's for holding water and stuff. That's
you're
stupid.
Ugly.
You're ugly. You're going to look like a goddamn Hello Kitty cosplay chick with that.
Hello,
on your, that little thing on your back.
Hi! I love cosplay the most!
No, you want a backpack that's
yeah, there we
the
go.
Size
that's,
of your back. There, Dan,
that's
there.
Some Dan Soder shit. Oh,
there.
Yeah. Ooh. I don't mean to get all E-40 on this, but ooh.
Ew.
I'll be walking around with a backpack full of knives in the post-apocalypse. Ooh. A rhinoceros. I got more horns than a rhinoceros. Yeah. Dude, I'm all about that. Why don't we order me one?
We're putting it together.
Cool. I want the bag.
You're making a decision on your bag really quick.
Stop it. Stop yelling at me. Put the bag in.
No, that's Dan's bag.
That's my bag.
This one.
Yes.
You see that thing on the bottom? One of the most embarrassing things I've ever seen. I did a Tough Mudder.
Yeah.
A few years back.
What?
And this guy, he was morbidly obese. He was in my starting pen, you know, because they stagger you. And he had a backpack that was filled with water.
Sweat.
And tubes coming out so that he could drink, sip, without having to grab anything. It was like an aqua pack.
Yeah.
A whole aqua lung on his back with straws.
Well, when that guy dies, we'll take his. He's not surviving the apocalypse.
But he ran 10 feet past the start sign, start line, and then stopped and walked the rest of the way. He just wanted to be there.
Dude, that's so funny. So he like ran and he's like, fuck this, man.
He did the start with us. We all, you know, ran out full pace. We've been training for this for months. He did the first 10 feet and
gave up.
And then did a walk around the entire course afterwards.
He just walked around and he didn't even do the things?
He couldn't physically get through most of the obstacles.
Yeah, well.
I don't know what he was there
Christine,
for.
Christine. This is a way. No one's getting a hydration pack. It's stupid.
Christine, you're already out of the team.
You're
fine,
wasting all your time on.
I'll have a hydration pack and you guys can't have any of my water.
No good. Problem. Yeah. Fight me with this bow staff. You'll see what happens.
Well, we're about to in the fishbowl.
That's right. We already had Foes Day, a fight day in the fishbowl.
Yeah, we got loose. Christine lost.
Wait, what's that? She.
What are all these things? What's that?
Nice fanny pack.
A holster. What's the holster? What's the holster for? A knife?
A gun?
It doesn't take a gun holster.
Oh, clips. Extra clips and shit. Hell yeah!
I should just go to what's the name of the Bass Pro Shop.
Shut up.
Just go spend a day there, get everything.
Oh, yeah. So that's really fun is to go to a Bass Pro Shop and walk around and do it like that. We're doing this on the radio, you idiot.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is how people are wasting a drive home.
And now we're sitting here wasting our stupid time looking at fucking backpacks.
Sorry. I just want to let the camera
know. I just brought up a three-fucking blade knife, and everyone's like, ooh.
I wanted to show the machetes.
Gotta be hydrated.
I didn't go to backpacks.
What?
I wanted to show you the machetes.
Yeah, Christine, I told you. I don't know what's going on.
You put, look at that hatchet. I mean, we're getting machetes.
Throwing stars.
Tactical flashlights are big, too. Ooh, buddy. Look at that middle one.
Yeah.
Game of Thrones shit. Cold steel. Oh, fuck yes.
That's 31. That's
yeah, it's nothing. Sorry.
Oh, by the way, just so you know, the Jagged Commando,
mm-hmm.
What do you think that costs?
$100.
What do you think it costs?
It's handmade at $300.
I looked it up already. I thought I really saw it.
Nope. $1,200.
Jesus Christ on a crisp. What? For that swirly blade?
$1,000.
It's going to last.
Goddamn right. You think I won't put that through somebody? Twist your hand. Go to the reviews. Ask if anyone's had their hand twisted when they murdered someone.
I like to twist when I jerk off. It's a nice twist.
Jay, what
story.
Would your what would you name it? Like Lucille?
Well, like, that'd be hack.
Your... No, I'm saying
it's been covered. What would my Lucille be? What would I say?
I would name that blade Twista, like the rapper.
It's not a bad one, Twista. That's not bad.
And then I'd rap fast.
I was trying to give it more of a. I was trying to give it more of like a meaning.
Okay.
But don't forget, everybody. I also need my finger holes knife. Also, with spikes on the finger holes.
And Jay brought up an excellent point on the drive to work today that I just want to reiterate on the air. We've been calling it hatchets when really...
We're idiots.
They're tomahawks.
Why were we wasting our time calling them hatchets?
It's tomahawk.
Not calling them tomahawks.
We refer to them as tomahawks.
Damn, the tomahawk guy. He's going to be a hatchet guy. The guy's not doing fucking line work on a fucking...
I'm Tomahawk Dan.
On a new townhouse development.
All right.
Tomahawk.
When the word spreads about my prowess in battle and in bed.
We're cave dwellers.
They sell tomahawks there.
They sell what?
They sell tomahawks on the site.
Oh, buddy, boy. Oh, buddy. Listen.
Tomahawk, also Atlanta's premier black circus stand-up comedian.
Is it right?
Combat and camping.
Oh, there we go.
Dude, look
But mostly
that.
Combat.
Look at that.
Oh, buddy. The Camelus?
Oh, dude.
Christine, stop picking girl ones.
Yeah.
Thank you.
She picked one called the Peace Pipe. She picked one legitimately called the Peace
Pipe.
Called
it's the called Peace Pipe?
It's called the Pretty Stick.
Yeah.
Oh, it's very pretty.
Collectors. Look at this.
Well, good. Put it in your sorority house. Go back.
She goes, this is for when I'm
the Camelus.
Chop down bad feelings.
Don't even go to the Camelus.
Dude,
now.
The Ranger.
So
look at
scarier.
Look at the Ranger. Go down.
The names are great.
The Ranger at the bottom. That's like just on my belt. Look at that fucking handle. Oh, you just ding that in someone's head.
Dan, this is a kitchen knife handle.
I hate you.
It's the stupidest handle in the whole goddamn thing.
Oh, sorry,
thing.
It doesn't look like a
you
fucking...
You picked the shittiest handle.
Oh, you want the fingerless gloves handle of all the tomahawks. That one, the Schwartz. Yeah.
That's just Dan, you really like... You're a simple dude.
It's a mean-looking motherfucker.
It's not, though. It's
look at that. Yeah,
no,
tactical.
The Red Rock Rifle Works one.
Let's go back to that. Let me see what one that one. The red. Look, no.
There.
God damn it.
No, you know what? Not that one. I'm sorry. The Fox. The Fox.
RMJ
the Fox.
Is the most expensive in the middle.
Come on. Look at that right there. It looks like you're fighting fucking vampires in the future.
No, it doesn't. It looks like it should belong on an affliction shirt.
Yeah.
Look at that one.
Who do you
go
think
down.
Is going
to
fight our future vampires, Dan?
All the
it's
way to the left.
Affliction dude.
The Berserker. Yeah. Tell me that one ain't cool.
It's better.
What?
It's better.
Dude, I'll lob it into your head. Better watch out. Better hook it.
You know, $800 of tomahawk? It's probably pretty good.
Dude, that thing will fucking slice and dice.
All right. So basically, and Dan have a switchblade, a twisty knife, and two tomahawks worth $10,000. All right, yeah. What do we got? Wait, go up, Christine. Was that a between the fingers knife? Up,
no.
Up.
Yeah. While we pick up two of those bad boys, I'm gonna need two of those stat. Actually, pick me up four.
Why is that?
Because I think
tomahawk?
I want to hold two, Jay. I want to hold two.
Yeah, buddy.
So when the big zombie comes to the barn, I can go. Oh, I've been waiting to blow off some steam.
Now hang on, I'm gonna correct Jacob. Jacob thinks he's such a fucking big dude to do woodsman. All of a sudden, now I get two straps on my book bag. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, my tactical bag.
Yes.
Jacob. And how am I possibly going to put my finger knives on either side of my one strap that goes across my chest so I can pull them out in an awesome fucking
two
way?
Straps.
Yeah, then I'm walking like the fucking dorky kid who did
so
his homework every day from school.
Two
my
knives.
Two straps.
Why don't
we
watch it? Why don't we watch it, bud?
I'm just saying, two straps. You got to be a Dan Soder to pull that off.
I will.
In the post-apocalyptic world.
I go, am I right? Dan Soder can pull that off, but I can't pull that off. I look like a knob walking with my big dorky backpack. I need it hanging over, and if someone comes to give me some zombie shit, or even some other survivor shit, they're coming out, and I could... I'll slit a throat.
Can I tell you where
I'll
mine are?
I'll stab you in the dick and the throat. One shot.
Mine are right on my hips. Pull them.
Doesn't make sense. I don't. Whatever you do, what you want with your finger.
Oh, so when you put your bag down, all of a sudden you don't have your finger blades?
In the post-apocalyptic world.
It's just, I think you're going to pull out those finger blades because you're in a situation you can't take your backpack off. It's too late.
Oh, yeah, well, what if your back? What if they come?
You're close quarters.
What if you're at the campfire and the fucking zombies come and you can't get to your backpack?
Christine, do me a favor. Can you slam the chair into the microphone a bunch?
I really do.
Thank you.
No, it adds ambiance.
She couldn't have banged it. Like a
That's Christine playing the tambourine on an album.
Yeah. Just like, boom. Hey, Stevie Nicks. Thanks for the rhythm set.
Dude, we got to get these. I mean, I know they're $295 each, and I know four will be a lot.
$200.
So what?
$200.
Care about something.
I'm going to do it.
Care about
I'm going to make Pete Dominic pay for it.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm going to make Pete Dominic pay for it.
I don't even know that's possible, but it's going to happen.
that's probably not... We probably can't lay down that decree at all. But I definitely want finger. I want finger knives.
Yeah, two of them, dude.
Two. I'll take the zebra print, if you were wondering.
Of course you
would. Zebra print?
They're all zebra print.
They're called push daggers.
We should take our first break, I think. Time to take our first break. We'll come back with more
we're
survival
not...
and, I guess, straightening Jacob's ass out.
Well,
Christine, bring us home with a little... chair on the microphone tune.
Yeah, there it is. Just like the old people used to sing.
Oh man, look at her. Look at that rhythm. Look at Armenian rhythm. 1-2 and 2 and 1-2 and 1-1. They're good people. We'll be right back. It's the Lost Tapes.
Tomahawk.
Tomahawk Dan.
Not even Tomahawk Dan. I'm just gonna start going by Tomahawk. How badass is that?
Tommy Hawk.
Let's stop trying to shoot you up.
Tommy Hawk.
No, stop.
Tom E. Hawk.
I don't like any of this.
Thomas Edward Hawk.
I don't like any of this. Thomas Edward Hawkins. I'm like, well, now the Tomahawk's gone.
Thomas Eugene Hawk.
Thomas Edwin Benedict Hawkins.
Theodore.
Theodore.
Eugene
Addison.
Hochstein.
Hawkerson.
Yeah. Hawkersteins.
This is so
of the Hawkersteins? He goes, I'm Tommy Hawk now.
He goes, Tom Hawk.
He goes, Theodore. Theodore Eugene.
Theodore would be this. It'd be
Hawkinsworth.
Theodore Aldous Emery Hawkinson. Oh, no, I go by Tom Hawk now. Tom A. Hawk.
Oh, Bonfire's been going. We'll be right back. It's the Lost Tapes.
Sorry.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Kung Fu's going to do you no good against Tomahawk.
My name's Tomahawk.
Tomahawk and Bo.
I was born. Oh, dude. Bo and Tomahawk? Is that our post-apocalyptic names?
I like it. Bo and Tomahawk?
Jacob, your blades.
Why do they call him Bo? And that's when you get a crack in the top of your head.
Yeah. And Jacob, your blades, all right?
I'll take that name.
I feel like Witski, DJ Lou, holds like a big, like a crazy too heavy battle axe.
Yeah.
and giant cinder block sledgehammer.
I was going to say should
be Black Lou. Yeah. Like cinder block sledgehammer.
Like steel?
Yeah.
You already said I was the zombie.
Oh, right. Zombie. No, you're our zombie. All right, Battle X. I think Battle X is now Black Lou.
Black Lou, your Battle X. You cool with that? What would you prefer something else? Broadsword?
I mean, if it was me, it'd probably be like a sword.
Yeah, hell yeah.
A sword?
Like Michonne style from Walking Dead.
What's up, Michonne? Okay, so he wants katanas.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. No, neither of us are a katana guy.
I'm Tomahawk.
It's absolutely fine. Christine, what are you? Pussy.
Are you display knife?
For display only. There you go. There you go, Black Lou.
Christine, I feel like you would rock like a machete, like a South American machete very well.
Christine?
Yeah, like, you know those jungle machetes?
No, wait, you already gave her a name.
Giggles? Blow our cover?
No,
we're going to call her Blown Cover?
Oh, yeah, she's the marching band.
The marching band plays whenever she comes, but what the fuck was her name?
Flags?
Flag girl.
Flag girl, yeah. That's what it was.
Everyone in the post-apocalypse thinks we're being homophobic at first, but then they're like, oh, no, you shouldn't flag. Got it. Hey, so flag girl's coming. And it's like, pum, 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 dun, 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 dun. What's that music?
What?
Flag girl.
I'll tell you, in a rare show of respect to Christine, I will say, she could put the flag on it and be the girl version of the bow staff person, because she can twirl the bow. Sharpen one of those ends up, now it's really fun. Flag with a sharp point on the other end.
And you guys are a couple, so it makes sense. You guys have similar weaponry.
Yeah, I taught everything I know.
Like, my lady would probably have to be an axe girl. Sure, she could be a hatchet, but maybe just carries a full axe.
A big axe.
Big axe.
I want the curvy sword.
Oh, that's her Armenian.
The handle with the thing.
That's her Armenian blood coming out.
Flag girl. What are you talking about, Sinbad?
I want the one to cut everyone up.
What do you want, One-Eyed Willie? Talk me again. That Aladdin?
No, I guess it's Aladdin-y, but none of these are it.
You want the one that's got the big blade? Yeah, like
that wasn't it?
Yeah, up top to
up
the right.
Up top, wasn't it? In the middle?
That?
Yeah. I'm like, kinda. That's what I thought a machete was. Like, what the Grim Reaper has.
That's a sickle.
You want a scythe.
Is that what it's called?
Sickle or a scythe? Try sickle.
Scythe, no. S-C-Y-T-H-E.
Oh, yeah. I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You want
what's a sickle?
A sickle's the hands, you know, it's like the Russian, the Drago flag. See?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Which, by the way, would be much better than a scythe, for real, but I guess Christine wants to be the Grim Reaper.
You make that face at the zombies?
So like, one side's a flag, the other side's a scythe?
Yeah, that's pretty badass, actually.
Yeah.
It's not bad. When I said it out loud, I realized, look, I can't even say a bad idea.
I try to say a bad idea.
I try, and I make it all sound right when it comes together. All right. Christine's a scythe flag girl.
That's pretty badass, though. Good choice, Christine. You made it work. Black Lou, katana sword. Jacob, obviously knives. All sorts of knives.
DJ Lou, we will and go back as we drag him around as our personal zombie slave. We will tell the legend of when he used to be a nunchucks guy. Bone nunchucks.
Oh, I was going to say he is a six shooters. Just two simple six shooters.
Oh, you didn't think bone nunchucks?
I think Lou Witzke, he's like the, you know, one of those drunk gunslingers where he's just hammered, but he can shoot a fucking penny off a fence from 50 yards away.
It's not bad.
Like Doc Holliday style, you know what I mean? Before he got bit.
Yeah,
where he goes, what do you want to do? What do you want to do? You go, Lou, we got to get out of here. There's zombies coming. He goes, there's zombies coming. And he stands up and puts his gun holster on. He goes, hey, there's zombies coming. I'll be outside. He comes back in and they're all dead. Can I drink now?
And then you see there's a bite on his back. He didn't even know happened.
Yeah, he didn't even, he's hammered. And he's that's like, what he's like.
Oh, so he goes, I think I might have got like shrapnel or something.
Did you guys get bit by mosquitoes? What, Lou? Lou, what happened on your back?
Oh, dead rat. What's going on, man? What's?
He goes, I'm getting
you
hot.
Got bit. He goes, fuck you, I got bit.
You ever see Pearl Jam?
I got bit.
Live. You ever see zombies? Live.
Live.
Dude, hell yeah, dude. Lou Witzke is a fucking double. No, six barrel. Not a fucking. Not a 33. What are you fucking trying to kill a squirrel?
Six barrel gun, yeah.
God, dude, get the man a six shooter. That's kind of sick for the post apocalypse. Lou, how do you feel about that top one? The pressure gauge.
Yeah. Where the whole thing is the barrel. I love it. You know where you can keep that, Lou? Tucked between your tits and your corset.
You know what, Lou? I like you being a six shooter guy. Are you not on board with it?
Tucked between your tits for when guys try to get fresh with you at the saloon.
He goes, never. Why, I have never.
I mean, taking that hot ass Lou whiskey. Oh, are you?
Sorry,
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Maverick told me to keep you company for a little bit. Oh, you sultry bitch. Why are you looking at Kalichnikovs?
At what?
AK-47s. Christine, we're ordering things.
Yeah, we're definitely getting put on a list.
Why are you wasting time looking at handguns?
How to kill your boyfriend. What?
Get away with it. How to be an ethnic and kill your boyfriend scot-free.
What a specific Google. What a weird Google
term. Someone's typed that in before?
Oh my God, that came up like a popular search? Huh.
All right, Christine, you want to pick out your magic carpet before we get back to our fucking knives? Christine. You want to get some curly slippers?
Yeah.
Some curly toe slippers to put on?
Hey, Princess
Jasmine. Then we'll all wear flowing pants and like half top vests.
Hey, Princess Jasmine. Great. We're not trying to dress like fucking Chippendales from the Middle East.
Jay, what color veil do you want to wear? I don't want to bite off your style.
Christine's just humming A Whole New World as she's just slamming zombie head.
Look at that. Jacob was right. It does twist your hand.
Just pulling it out.
It really does.
Christine, little help over here. I can show you. She's just singing.
This is the last thing I'm just plays in her headphones all the time.
She's just killing multiple zombies. Just a weird smile on her face. You guys are having threesomes with zombies? Here you go. Nah, she's cool. She's cool. She gets a little annoying after you come.
She's down with it.
She's cool.
You put a muzzle on a brand new zombie, they're fuckable for a couple hours.
Hell, I'll tell you this right now. You make sure they don't bite you, you can tit fuck a zombie all day.
What's your zombie rule? I'll tell you what.
Tit fuck. TF all day.
If you're a necrophiliac, it's gotta be a little bit better.
That's Christmas. That's Christmas and your birthday.
You get to fuck a dead person and they're moving for you a little bit?
Moving and grooving. Or maybe that's their thing. Maybe necrophiliacs like the whole... Do you think when necrophiliacs...
Okay, before you ask, I just want to say... Jake, I see you throwing face. I'm not saying to fuck a dead... Well, you know, you only have a few hours. Like a brand new dead zombie. You're rolling your eyes. This guy's better than fucking a fucking brand new zombie.
Not one that's deteriorated.
It's brand new!
You don't wear shirts with holes in them.
How deteriorated? Yeah. Come on, man.
Come on. Just see a girl, like a nice thick zombie going by.
Thick ass zombie, but brand new.
Brand, like right off the boat.
Like OD'd in the locker room of a strip club.
She just walked out. She's finding her way out to the light.
Just walked out.
And by the way, you got
fresh wax.
You got a fuck muzzle on you. You throw it on her.
Yeah, you got a fuck muzzle.
Yeah, you put that on.
You put the bit in her mouth.
Yeah, you put down. You got your condom on. You got your Jimmy hat on.
I gotta tap out.
Yes, throw on your gym hat.
It's lit.
You bang it up. You're ready to go. Yeah.
Throw on your Jimmy hat.
Yes.
That's the funny thing to say as you're biting a package of them. You just finished muzzling your zombie and stretching her legs open. You go, I guess someone better strap up my gym hat. Have you met my friend Jim Hat?
He goes, better grab my bag. He goes, so anyways, you are... He's looking at his dick. He's
I'm a knife guy. I'm not a scientist. I don't know how this shit works.
He goes, you probably had this sooner than I did. Here we go. You ready to party?
And
let me line it up.
And
we're in.
There we go. Still warm?
Oh, hey.
Still warmer than I thought.
Yeah, see?
Warmer than I thought. Meh. Somewhere, meh. Someone listening right now. Meh. Someone listening right now driving their car is really like batting around the idea of, do they write a letter? Like, how do they complain about this? What we're doing right now exactly. What he's doing right here to a human being is abysmal. It's a horrific, horrific thing he's doing. But
we're talking zombie apocalypse.
To a made-up zombie, it's fine.
I know. You're getting a hole.
Listen, that zombie would kill you if you didn't rape it.
Eat your face.
And think.
And you don't know what the laws of consensual sex are with zombies.
I couldn't.
I don't. What zombie law, even?
We have to go to Haiti to figure that out.
They haven't evolved that far.
Consent is consent with me.
What?
If I would have to get a zombie consent.
Excuse me, I noticed you just stumbled out of cheetahs. I was wondering if you'd want to have sex.
Brains.
Yeah, brains? Say brains again if you mean yes.
Brains.
Growl if you want this dick. Come chase me. All right, me. Baby girl, you don't got to ask this boy. Stop pursuing me.
She goes to rip his shirt off.
All right, chill, babe. Damn, girl.
Just going to grab you here. Yeah. Muzzle you.
There you go. It goes over and around and on the crown.
That's a Windsor knot. I'm an idiot.
I almost got my dick bit off.
Yeah, this show gets weird.
I almost got my dick bit off.
Yeah. Yes, that's exactly what I want.
A kitchen knife handle.
Dude, I'll fucking kill you with that.
So really, now you're taking Christine's...
22-inch...
I can show you the world knife.
Dude, that's a 22-inch sword, and that goes on my back. And that's fucking Mountain Dan. That's
not
Tomahawk.
It's not going to be easy to take out. I think those thick top slim bottom things are going to be hard to take out of the sheath quick off your back.
Well, don't worry about it.
I don't think that comes in a sheath. I think that hangs on your
side
sash.
I'm cool with that. Why don't you worry about it? Why don't you go play sticks out in the woods? Real men got swords.
Grab whatever you want, baby girl.
Yeah, baby girl.
Yeah, I'll get to try your sword. I knock it out of your hand with my staff.
There you go. Go ahead.
This.
Yes. Oh.
Wow. That's pretty great.
I want mm-hmm. that.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to cut your own nip off.
That's Fly Girl. That's Fly Girls. By the way, I love that we do have an actual fucking shopping cart building.
Oh, without a doubt. We're going to put this out there for the campers.
Yeah.
Campers want to know. All right, what's next? Canteens. Go.
Need good canteens.
I'm joking. I don't care about our canteens.
Why? You need that.
A good canteen?
What do we got so far? We got that sword?
We only have the backpack and these two swords. We haven't added the other sword.
We got to get Jay a backpack.
Is there anything that will turn my piss into water?
That's not real.
That's
what's that fun one? There's some fun stuff here.
Well, these are the
Hobbit your question?
Lord of the Ring swords.
Is okay. It not a thing?
Do you have Conan and the Barbarian swords?
Are we all 100% certain it's not a thing? I got dismissed twice there, and Christine did it half-heartedly, backing up Dan.
Jay?
She loves to gang up on me.
Jay?
Yeah.
Stop it.
No.
It's the end of the world.
There's other people around to tell you you're wrong.
But you don't know if I'm wrong.
Piss
Dan goes,
pills.
You're wrong. You can't turn... Piss pills? No. Is there any sort of thing you could piss into that turns your piss into drinkable water? That's
like
what
water
I...
Water world?
Yes.
I think you just drink your piss. Oh, wait, no, here.
That's who backed you up, Dan.
Oh, man.
I think you just piss in your own mouth. Is that what you think, you dipshit? That's ridiculous.
No, she's saying she thinks you can drink your own pee, but this is personal water filter. So what is it?
That's for drinking out of the
I've got those.
Swamp or something.
I got those taken care of. Don't worry.
You got them?
Yeah.
When?
I told you already. I already did one round.
You got a thing you could drink swamp water?
I got a thing where you can purify water. I have multiple pills and drops and a filter. I have an emergency blanket. I have a fucking... I got a couple things, dog. I got a flint.
Just no machete.
I waited for you to pick out the weapons.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah. And I needed a pack.
Well, good news. Here's what I bring to the table. Two sticks and an insubordinate who wants to turn on me every time I say, is there something you can turn your piss into water?
Dude, Fly Girl, it'd be an honor to fight the undead beside her.
Oh, look at that. Oh, it exists, everyone. Now, guess what, Christine? I noticed that thing is about the size of a dumpster. The machine does it, but guess now what? For being insubordinate? Now you got to carry that on your back. You're dragging the water purifier. Happy? Asshole drags the purifier.
Christine, as I told you.
Well, let's slave zombie Lou help.
As I told you before, Christine, I have several water purification systems. This is unnecessary.
Ew.
Dan, am I going to have to stick for you, buddy?
Oh, dude.
I think they said they
don't make it so. I don't want internal struggle here.
When I reveal my main weapon, just know what you know what I'm bringing.
You're being such a Shane right now. And I go, Jacob will get that because he watches the show. But you're being a real Shane right now, interfering in my relationship with Christine.
Are you calling yourself Rick?
Do you guys not see me as Rick?
I was more...
Wait.
I thought I was...
This is shocking me, too.
I thought I was the white trash guy that hates his brother.
Daryl.
Yeah, Daryl.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, yeah, Daryl. You're a total Daryl.
Thank you. So, Rick.
Cool.
Thanks, bro. Christine, you're Chinese Glenn.
Yeah. I'll be Glenn.
You're the Chinese guy.
You're Chinese Glenn.
I'll remember you.
No, I don't get Maggie. I'm the only chick.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys.
You're Glenn.
Do you want to be the pregnant wife that dies?
Yeah, real nice. You want to be the pregnant wife who dies?
No. What pregnant wife dies?
Rick's wife. Spoiler alert.
You can be that girl.
No. Who wants to be her?
I don't know. You were yelling about something.
Yeah, I don't want to be Glenn. Sorry, I don't want to be Asian boy, guys.
Are you going to be Abraham, the big ginger?
Why is it always going to be race about you?
Calm down, Flag Girl.
Yeah.
Well, Flag Girl gets amped up. Thank God she only has a scythe flag.
Carry the piss.
By the way, that flag's going to probably slow down your scythe twirling.
Oh, dude, I can't wait to reveal my weapon.
It's like a parachute. You're going to stab yourself right in the twat.
Yeah, I'm telling you right now, they're going to get on the inside quick. You better have some hand blades.
Christine, you have to cough up the $600 and get yourself some finger knives.
Yeah, we're gonna have to come out of pocket on this one. we're already carrying the weight on most of these. You're gonna have to buy yourself some hand blades because I do not trust your scything.
Your scything's ridiculous.
Your scything's
not. It's gonna be all when you start flipping it around and the wind's catching the flag and then you're gonna slice Dan across his cheek. That's not a cool apocalypse story.
I'm gonna take one. Yeah, they're like, did a zombie get you? I go, flag girl. When we meet a new group of fucking survivors. What happened to your cheek? Oh man, did the undead bite you? No, flag girl was whipping it around and the fucking strong wind pushed her into it.
Christine, go to a butterfly knife skill thing.
You want a butter knife, huh?
They have by the way, they have training butterfly knives that won't hurt you that you could figure all the moves on.
Dude. Yeah, I mean, we have to buy those.
They're right on that page.
Because I want to get so good at flipping a butterfly knife.
Go back to the trainer ones, Christine, on the page before. But then go to a video. Bring up a YouTube video.
Let's just see the training ones real quick.
Of knives. Yeah. Go down. Down. Down.
Oh, I get so there.
All the way on the right.
Training knives.
Yeah.
What is that?
Training knife.
What's that? What is that?
Training sword.
What is it made of?
Half polypropylene. So probably like...
Get two of those immediately. Buy two of those immediately.
Okay.
Lou, your training begins. Black Lou.
Oh, yeah. Black Lou is training. Go back, please.
We're going to have so many fake weapons in this office. They can't even take away the office.
They can't get mad at us for that. But we're going to be very threatening. We will hold all of our weapons on the show.
We got your training knives now, because now we got to learn how to do butterfly knives. So when we walk in, when they come to take the thing, and I go, like, I can put my feet up on the desk.
Christine, do you think the word is tomahawk? I want to get me a tomahawk.
But that'd be great. They go, guys, you're no longer in Studio 5.
Well, she won't go to the butterfly knives for some reason.
I was just on them.
You weren't.
Guys, you guys are missing my air butterfly.
No, the trainers.
Guys, can you stop fighting?
I can't.
On the way. I know.
Stick fight. Kink, kink, kink. Christine's looking for sword canes.
Well, I clicked off the page and I can't find it.
What are you, a fucking international spy?
hey, penguin.
Hey, Batman. It's me, Christine.
Training knives.
Christine,
training
this back right there. There it is.
Yeah, dude.
$50 for a trainer.
Dude, I don't care. Just buy one of those because that's just fun to have in the office. Jacob, just doing your work.
You know what? It's not going to be that good because it's not going to move the way the other one.
How do you know?
Go to a video of knife skills.
How do you know that's not weighed down?
Look at the thickness of the handle. Would you agree with me, Jacob, what I'm saying? When you see those knives that people flick around, it's not like that. That's got too much of a pocket knife feel to it.
Plus the clip. Not practical.
Yeah, it's not practical. Yeah, I agree.
We're learning how to flip the knife, you fucks.
Look at that. Just doing that shit looks so goddamn fun.
it does look cool.
You think this goop kid still wears his keys around his neck?
You look like a pure psychopath doing that, though.
No, you wouldn't. You look so badass.
No, you don't.
Look at this guy.
Fucking nutball.
Looks like a Jake Paul, Logan Paul brother no one paid attention to.
They left in the basement and never fed.
Look at that. That's real time.
At the Bonfire SXM, we'll tweet out the video. Ooh, listen
to the butterfly knife skills.
Listen to the knobby music that goes along with it.
Oh, is this playing on the video?
Yeah.
What a jag.
Whoa.
Doesn't matter.
Whoa.
I want to do every one of those things.
I bet they have names for the tricks. Like, this is called the Triple Betty.
Oh! Whoa.
Guess who's just fucking tomahawking him in the chest when he tries that with me? Cat, cat,
yes.
End of the world.
And then when you take his butterfly knife, because that's all he had, don't you then want to be able to use it right?
No. I go, look what I took off this fucking loser.
This holds nothing for you? That's fine.
I'm a tomahawk guy.
I'll be the butterfly knife guy.
Cool. Guess what I'm going to do? A somersault roll into a tomahawk throw.
What, while I'm distracting with my skills?
Yeah. You're going, oh.
I'm like, oh my God.
You do the Robin
Williams?
You're
probably saying yourself, does this guy have three hands? And then you tomahawk him the side.
Do you do Robin Williams as you're doing the tomahawk?
Oh, look out.
Hey, Mr. Knifey. It's pretty funny.
Is there any way to find out? I also would like to get into a deck of card throwing.
Gambit style?
Yeah. Sharp cards, Christine? Sharp cards, Christine?
Sharp cards. I think you just go full throwing stars.
Unless you
want to go the machete route and throw knives.
No. I don't want to throw knives either. I think a deck of cards.
I don't think they have those. Sharp cards.
Christine, can you look up a sharp deck of cards, please? Mm-hmm. Can you throw throwing cards?
Oh, that would be good, though, if you shuffled as you analyzed the situation.
I had so many different Chinese stars growing up, and they are so not as fun as you hope.
8-point silver throwing star, 5-point, 7-point. I like an 8-point. I feel like when I let it loose, it's got to do a lot of damage.
Throwing?
Luno Lu just sent me this video. It's apparently a knife fight breaks out.
Hell yeah, play.
Between Sikhs at a golden temple.
Oh, shit. You never think about that in a knife fight. You really do have to touch the guy's back in front of you, like, hey, I'm behind you. He's like, oh, sorry. I was really fucking winding up there. I didn't mean to almost take off your fucking face.
Fuck you. Paul, I'm right behind you, man.
Paul, 6 o'clock, behind. Like a waiter, behind.
I got
behind.
Your six.
Behind.
I got your six.
Dude, look at that. On the stairs, I have the higher ground. Ah!
Wow, that was pretty funny the way he bailed. We'll put it out at the Bonfire SXM.
That ain't gonna be like our fights. I'm gonna be doing some somersaults, backflips, and shit.
No. Is there any throwing cards?
Yes.
Thank you.
But how are you gonna weaponize them?
Why don't you go to a video of some throwing card skills?
Dude, there's no way they have those. You've looked these videos up?
Nope.
You just know that your people are out there?
Well, I think there is. I don't speak in definites like you two guys tell me there's no way to turn my piss into water. I would do research first. I keep telling Christine, a smart man says, I don't know the answer to that. I will find out the answer. But, you know, people just want to puff their chest out, just go, no, you're an idiot. It's a dumb idea. It's not a real thing. And then you'll be like idiots.
You trying to catch a hatchet?
They drink recycled piss on a space station.
Huh?
I think they drink recycled piss on a space station.
I didn't know that, but apparently Christine and Dan think they're smarter than astronauts.
I am. I'm smarter than that. You can't do that. You should tell them that you can't do that.
That's not cool. That's not even real. You're stupid.
You should. When you're talking to a spaceman, you should tell him you shouldn't do that because it's stupid. I don't want to.
Hey, flag girl, throwing cards.
I'm looking for the video.
Man, you're about to catch a throwing card if she had one on her.
Well, I'm just trying to build up because Terminator timeline. We're about to fight in the fishbowl with with stamps.
Oh yeah. Oh, look at this. This guy's popping balloons, Jay. How soft do you think these zombie heads are?
What's he doing? Oh, it's the kid from Stranger Things. Yeah. Yeah, I got that. I'm good on that. I'm good with that.
There's no
way. I want throwing cards.
Dude, there's no way you could do throwing cards.
Dan. You say there's no way. I say why not.
You're right. Oh, look at these guys. They do cool shit like that. We'll tweet that at the Bonfire SXL. Oh.
Pew.
This kid's awesome. And he spray paints. He throws cards and spray paints. What's that, Jacob? What are you showing, Jay?
Just a picture of your mom in her underwear. Jacob.
I'll kill you. I'll kill all of you. What is it?
It's the D in her panties.
Drinking piss.
Dude, not bad. Not bad for her age. Killing it.
It's broke now. You guys broke everything.
Oh,
this is you throwing a card. Yep. Ooh.
Is how you sound throwing cards. Boo.
Here's a card.
Ace of Spades.
Yeah, there's no way that'll work. Stick to the staff, dude. You're trying to fucking.
What am I gonna pull out a staff every goddamn day?
You have your knife hands, your hand knives.
What if there's one zombie we have to deal with one day?
And hand knife.
I feel like taking slave zombie DJ Lou's his light work. And I'm like, oh, you know, while I'm sitting up here on watch, let me see if I can kill this one singular zombie with my throwing cards. Why would that bother you? It's my downtime.
Fine. Buy throwing cards.
I protect the perimeter. It matters to you how I do it?
Dude, I told you.
I come back and tell you I did it with throwing cards. You're not going to be like, that's fucking badass, dude.
I'm mapping our way to the CDC. We have to learn how to get there.
No, you know, you've been saying you're mapping us to the CDC, but I feel what's going on. I saw your notebook, Stan. I know you're trying to get us to your fucking friend in San Francisco because you think his goddamn offensive playbook is going to get us out of this mess. Well, it's not, Dan. We need scientists, not offensive coordinators.
Blades? I'm going to need you to tell Bo that I'm trying to get us to Colorado for some goddamn clean water.
This ain't the route to Colorado.
It's the CDC first to get simple medicines. We have people dying out here, and I'm worried about them.
There's actually the Batman throwing stars?
Well, we got to buy a bunch of those. Dude, how great would that be if Pete Dominic's walking down the hallway? It's like, you know what happens when you snitch on the bonfire? You get dealt with.
I more think that he walks in and we're picking out weaponry.
Oh, yeah.
What's up?
Oh, dude, I have a Bane mask.
What's up?
Only one to admit that you lied.
Peter. Well, some of these throwing stars are just completely non-practical.
The Batman ones are not.
Impractical.
They're awesome.
Non-practical.
Jacob, we're not building our knife pack properly. Those hand knives are pretty pricey.
What? Was this whole thing to be like at a low cost?
I don't know. I don't really know if I want to spend $6,000.
I'm not spending $1,200 on a curvy knife.
No.
No, I would. You want to go buy like a mass-produced one, but a good one. That's why I was giving you the brands that.
Say Buck Alpha again. Say Buck Alpha again.
I don't want to.
I kind of want a Buck Alpha. Can you search your Buck Alpha?
Don't make me get my bow.
Oh, dude. You and Jacob just bowing it off?
Oh. First I'll trip you, and then I'll hold the bow to the bottom of your chin.
There are plenty other brands, but...
It's fine.
Listen, let's take a break.
Take a break.
We're going to come back. We're all going to get together. Jacob, we're going to clear up this zombie rape that you have a court case pending.
We're a crew. We're the crew. We can't end fight like this. It's already falling apart. The only person being cool at all is Zombie Slave.
You know what's so funny is me just going up to talk to Zombie Lou at the end of the night while I'm working. I go, you know, it's just sometimes like Blades is upset and Flag Girl, like she came back with Blades. He goes, Pearl Jam Live. He just says, no, he just. He also just talks and drops.
I have to wake the crew up. He's learning.
But he just talks and drops.
He remembers.
He goes, what childhood? He goes, I don't know, Jake. He goes, I go, all right, good night. And he goes, ciao, beautiful.
You go, watch this. And you bring everybody out and you go by Lou and you throw a softball up in the air and bang it with the bat and you hear ting. And he goes, he remembers.
He remembers. I'm telling you. I remember watch. I go, like Pete dancing icon Pete Wentz. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Scott, yeah. The post-apocalyptic bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Hello, does.
Still one of my favorite moments in a movie. Hey, it's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J. Okerson, and these are the motherfucking Lost Tapes.
Yay.
Apocalypse style. I said Dan Soder and Big J. Okerson. What I meant was Tom A. Hawk and Bo.
Bo.
And just Bo.
B-O.
B-O. Not even Bo. B-A-U.
Nope.
Just Bo. And Flag Bo. Girl and Zombie Lou. And Battle Axe, Black Lou, and fucking Blades.
Black-a-axe.
Black-a-axe is such a cool name.
Black-a-axe Lou?
Black-a-axe Lou. Blacks. Blacks?
I like
B-A-L-A-X. B-L-A-X-E?
No. B-L-A triple X.
How do you feel about that? That's like that's definitely like a fucking 90s black male porn star name.
Blacks.
Blacks.
Absolutely. Yeah. You have a tattoo of a gun in your hip?
Yeah, Lexington Steel and Mr. Marcus. Was
Devin Weed. That was the guy. Devin Weed was the guy who had the the double barrel gun tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
It's so funny to see guys who have thuggy tattoos in porn.
Yeah.
Because
they're trying to be sensual.
I know they're fucking, but even they're not being sensual. No. They're still being very vulnerable, for
they're
sure.
They're naked.
You're naked. There's a bunch of people around filming you.
It says, like, thugs
don't
die.
Gotta keep a bone.
You're like, no. Oh. You're like, don't look at me weird. I'll fuck you up.
It's like, I look at it. Why does that gaffer keep checking out my piece?
Oh, God. He's just, all right, dude. You're fucking good about to catch these hands.
Have you ever filmed yourself fucking before?
One time I filmed myself getting a blowjob, and that was all right. One time I tried filming fucking, me and the girl watched it back, we're like, and delete. Goodbye. It was on one of those old digital cameras. It was Mike's girlfriend, and we were at her apartment. She's like, let's film it. I was like, all right. We filmed it, and then we both came, and then we watched it. We're like, so we're going to delete. Yeah, this is weird. I didn't know my side looked like that when I fucked. A gross side angle.
Let's, now I know this is the lost tape. Terminator Timeline.
Terminator Timeline.
I think on the live show yesterday.
Yeah.
We've had the audience maybe got involved in that one.
About sex videos?
Yeah. Sex videos going awry.
Oh, so I retold this story.
Yeah, but you told it really quick.
I retold it really quick.
Yeah, so what?
So what?
So
dang
what?
Us. What are you going to do? Go to Don Wicklin and Jack Vaughn?
Donnie Wicks.
Donnie Wicks, dude. I was talking to DeRosa.
Jackie V.
I was talking to DeRosa in China, and I go, yeah, he went to, I was talking about the Pete thing, which, you know, obviously Pete was on the show yesterday, but I talked to DeRosa about it in China, and I go, he went to Jack Vaughn and Don Wicklin. He goes, who's Don Wicklin? I go, he's like the boss, like talk radio. He goes, sounds like he's a boss. He's, what are you, in Wicklin's office? He really does have boss name. So yeah, we talked about that. Today, we're talking about surviving the zombie apocalypse.
We are. I think we're doing pretty good. We're spending too much time on backpacks.
I already picked mine out, dude. I was quick.
Yeah, you're good to go. What happened to Jacob? We lost Jacob.
Blades?
What happened to Blades?
I mean, to pull the curtain, it is Yom Kippur, so he's probably out in the hallway just punching the wall.
He's praying? I thought maybe he was praying.
No, we catch him out there. He's got a prayer mat. You're like, did you flip to Islam on Yom Kippur? Fucking spoiler.
And we're all assuming the apocalypse happens while we're at work. So we have, this is our team.
Yeah, so we're together.
We're aware of that.
First off, we got to get out of old 1221.
You have to get out of the building?
Yeah.
That's going to be a video game in itself.
And I'll tell you this, that's the first level. That's how you learn all the controls.
Who's your enemies, Lou? Who are you going for first? All the other engineers? How about this piece of shit through the window over here?
Yeah, he likes wrestling. He's cool.
Nah, that guy's with me. He's good.
He's good people?
That guy's with me. Blaze!
Just remember, the apocalypse has room for only one engineer.
Yep.
Oh, you're right. So I got to take out other engineers.
Yeah.
Dude, any other voice guys are getting cleared out by me.
Anybody with halfway a deep voice, you got to take out.
Black Lou says actually he's getting ready to join with everybody and then kill them in their back, like behind their back.
What he does is he shuts the door and then he puts the door, the axe through the handle of the door, and he goes, I'm sorry.
He's like, I'll be your black guy. I'll be your black guy group.
And they go,
they'll take him in all trusting, and they'll kill everyone while they're asleep, and then we'll go take their shit with them.
Yep. This is working out great. Blades, right.
You gotta play
you'll
on
be on the PAX.
You got to play on everyone's fear of, even in the apocalypse, looking racist.
Yeah. They're going to go like this.
So please help me, guys. Please help me out. I have a lot of skills. I could help you and your crew. And I'll be like, oh, my God, get in here. We really wanted a person of color.
That's really funny, though. The guy in the race war that's afraid of looking like a racist. It's like full-on race war. It just happens, and he's like... Was that racist? Was that racist when we were fighting the group of Mexicans and I yelled out a couple words and they go, yeah, it's a race war. You're supposed to be racist.
I watched another Manson thing on Fox the other night.
Yeah,
the
Lost Charlie. Tapes. Chuck.
It was called The Lost Tapes.
Chucky
Jacob, one, you do look bizarrely like Charles Manson. Bizarre.
You told me to grow this.
Yeah. No, that wouldn't be the
beard.
Same. No, not now.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, your actual structure, like
I
your eyes.
It was the beard.
No, not the beard at all.
He's saying your cold, dead eyes are similar to Charles Manson.
You look like a young Charles Manson. You look way better than Charles Manson at your age.
Young,
you look like
Chucky
young Charles Manson, yeah. So it was called The Lost Tapes. And I got to tell you, these, first of all, talking to people who used to be in a cult, how can you ever take them seriously?
Yeah, they got,
like,
it's the ultimate,
like,
bamboozle.
Look how ridiculous I was.
Yeah, you know what it is? It's the ultimate bamboozle. It's like someone that got caught in a pyramid scheme telling you that was a good business decision.
But I forget always that Charles Manson, because it was hidden under all that hippy-dippy love and family and pure acceptance, and you're an outcast in the world, you're a brother and a sister here, everyone's fucking... Everyone's having sex. I forgot that the thing he was trying to ignite was the race war, because under all that peace and love, super, super racist.
Oh, real big racist. Helter Skelter. Yeah. All about fucking starting a race war.
I keep always forgetting it was about a race war.
Yeah, his goal wasn't just to fuck. Like, when you watch, what was the documentary on Netflix about the place in Oregon?
Wild Country.
Wild Country. That is like, it's more like spiritual enlightenment. They're trying to fuck and then they're trying to get power. You know what I mean? But Charles Manson's like, I just want to see them all bleed. Mexicans, blacks, Asians. And you're like, oh, fuck, dude. You're a real shit dude.
Yeah. She's like, you know, they're just animals. And then we just listen to music and love and
hold each other. But they're
make
animals.
Love to each other.
Charles.
And the next thing you know, Cable guy comes. I don't know why I'd be a cable guy in a cave. Cable guy shows up. It's one of these goddamn colors. Yeah. Trying to fish his way around, eyeing me up in my beautiful white skin.
Take America back from the Jews.
Whoa.
And it's Yom Kippur.
Hey! What a timely drop.
I mean, he really... It's
Young Charles Manson, not a bad looking guy.
Not at all.
I'll take it.
But he's super into sharks and knives.
Oh.
No, listen. Good looking enough to... organize a fleet of women that all fucked him and would fuck whoever he told them to fuck.
They murdered for him.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot. They also murdered for him, Jacob.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to think about Charles Manson.
You think you got that much swag going in there having chicks take a life for you?
Why don't you see?
That's my CD cult picture.
He goes, do you like, you know what's better than compact discs? Nothing.
Jacob, who can you manipulate to make sure we don't end up in this other studio?
Yeah, we're going to need you to go full cult leader.
Nobody.
You can't get a girl on this floor to kill for you?
Dude, I'll clean up the bodies. Who's your squeaky Froman?
You can easily. You're thinking of Abe Froman mixed with Squeaky Fromm.
Damn it. The Sausage King of Chicago.
That's the daughter. No, I'm thinking of Squeaky Froman. Yeah, no, the Sausage King of Chicago's daughter.
Dude, she was in Charles Manson's cult. These guys got to read up on this
guys,
shit.
Guys, I know who Squeaky Fromm is. You think there's only one Squeaky in the world? Okay. All right. Okay.
I'll be out in the hallway with people that actually read.
Okay. All right, then. I guess you guys only use the internet for porn, huh?
Fuck, I'm an idiot.
Who's your Squeaky Froman?
Yeah, the Sausage King of Chicago.
The daughter of the Sausage King of Chicago. We could all hope for a Squeaky Froman one day.
A woman that would kill and link a sausage? Get out of here.
Not afraid of a casing?
You can't afford that.
Oh, yeah.
You tell them the Squeaky Froman, the daughter of Abe Froman, the Sausage King of Chicago is here.
He's going to murder everyone in this house.
I will say a lot of the girls, not that great looking. All good bodies, though.
Solid bods, goofy faces. That's the Bobby Kelly rule. That's
no shit, man. They're all
Bobby always used to say that.
I like a girl with a good body and a goofy face, dude.
They're all bad faces, really good bodies.
Yeah. Dude, Damian Lewis was talking about how, you know, he's in the new Tarantino movie about all this.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and he was like, they didn't tell anyone in the cast what happens on the last 20 pages.
Oh, Sharon Tate gets killed.
Yeah, but how it
happens.
Spoiler
alert.
Yeah, sure. No, she lives through this one.
How it happens.
It's like
they stab all of her friends in hangar.
It's Inglourious Bastards where they change the ending to what you think happens. And no, she fights her way out.
Charles Manson actually did the murders himself. Yes. Yeah.
And by the way, in a cape. You go, that didn't happen at all.
And he has power.
But he was talking about it, and I was like, fuck, I want to see this movie. It's going to be awesome. It's Leo, Brad Pitt, the Australian girl from Wolf of Wall Street, Margot Robbie. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. She plays Sharon Tate.
Really? So it's about the murderer again.
It's not...
It'll be a Tarantino one, though.
But it's about the turn of 50s into 60s. Kind of like how Boogie Nights...
Is it like Summer of Sam, actually, that way? Because Summer of Sam isn't really about...
About
Dave Berkowitz.
Yeah. It's that's more of a way to say it. From what I...
It's about Mike Berkowitz.
It's about the agent, super agent
Mike Berkowitz.
He's ageless. He can get you any deal you want. Jacob, who's going to be your sausage queen?
Who are your sausage
queen? I was going to say Charles Manson. I look like him like before he got crazy eyes, but then Christine put the side-by-side photo and... No, the eyes are pretty much similar. Yeah.
Well, I'm just waiting for you to go.
You could have crazy eyes if you crazy-eyed stared people.
I like to think he has
give a cold
deep
stare
thinker,
to Lou.
Deep thinker eyes.
Yeah.
Give a cold dead stare to Lou. Good though.
Dude, I'll tell you this, it shook the room.
Oh. You can see for a second, it definitely like it got
anything.
It.
Dude, I saw you do it, and I went like this. I don't like
that. Yeah, that was real.
You know when a dad shaves its beard and its kid doesn't know?
I was
like this.
Look at Jake's face in the picture. He goes, he trying to take my big head Todd and the Monsters CD?
Which one do you want?
I have crazy eyes and he just looks sad. Charles Manson.
Well, in his prison blues.
Did you ever hear Silverchair's follow-up album? Right.
If there wasn't for the drug problems, those guys would have been bigger.
An eating disorder. R.I.P., I think.
What happened?
It's over.
Oh, creepy. Jacob's dead eyes. Do it.
I can't.
I'll go to you. Dan. Can I be a co-leader?
Look. That moment.
No, you're too caring. You're too soft. You're too nice. What about me?
No, it's not real.
Damn. It's not real. You know it's not real. You know it ain't real.
Christine's associate, Pat. She could probably do a good one.
You understand?
Do
I
dead eyes.
I look so hot in this photo. I thought, come on. This is my photo.
Do dead eyes.
This is the one.
That's pretty creepy. I just...
Let me see.
Yeah, you gotta do it. Come on, go to that space. It's the best.
I can't do it.
No.
My eyes aren't deadening enough.
I see your eyes go blank. Let me try again.
All right.
It's not blank.
No. Sorry, bud. Let me try again. Here it is. I like that so much more. Let me try again. Hold on, let me try again.
That's creepy.
It's not. Yeah. It's not.
Side eyes. Don't work on.
All right. I don't need you.
You look sleepy.
I am sleepy. I'm so sleepy.
You appear sleepy.
Always.
DJ Lou.
Dead eyes.
I can do it when I'm drunk, but I don't think I have.
Yeah, your dead eyes are
no. Those. You do it when you're drunk.
Yeah. I don't think I have the anger in me when I'm sober.
Those are lazy eyes.
I got it now.
All right.
Don't do it to me, Jacob. I've nightmares.
All right. Here we go.
Yeah, Jacob's got it.
Don't you, Jacob?
Murderer.
Jacob's definitely got it.
Straight up has it. Jacob doesn't do it.
Jacob, stop.
Yeah.
I don't like that. That's going to wake you up from a nap.
I don't like this.
I just looked over and saw him. He was like,
I loved it.
You're fucking, God damn it, your Manson eyes. Manson eyes.
Scott, Charles Manson eyes.
He got Charles Manson eyes.
He will kill you.
He will fuck you.
He will take you from your family. He's precocious. And he knows just what it takes to make a dumbass kill.
That song they played at Dos Caminos so much when I was doing lunch, it was on one of the lunch mixes. She's precocious.
All the DJs think he's smart, Scott. Charles Manson eyes.
He got Charles Manson eyes.
Dude, they did that song. What other song? There's certain songs that when you think that, I just go right back to filling salsa trays.
But you gotta like Betty Davis eyes.
No, because of that.
Hmm?
That, because of that.
Now, give it another second, Dan.
So good.
Mm-hmm.
No, because I'd be like this.
No,
I ordered the steak tacos. And you're like, yeah,
push,
I'll be right back.
Push through that. Push through that.
Okay. Her hair is hollow gold.
Ooh. Her lips sweet surprise. Sweet surprise. Her hands are never
cold. She got Betty Davis hands. Turn the music
on. Oh, look at the video. She'll be a friend of your mom's.
Dude, the one that I'd want to bang. That's like a girl that looks like a girl that Trish used to, I mean, that Gary used to knit.
Of course.
Gary get girls
Kim
like that.
Kim Barnes, definitely. She pantsuit rock.
Hell yeah. He was after that Murphy Brown look. Uh-oh, she's going all Paula Poundstone.
Oh, total Poundstone.
That's Poundtown.
She's precocious.
She's hot, though.
She's pretty. For an older lady.
Shut
she
up.
She reminds me of my first stepmother, Kathy.
I bet she's got great clavicles.
Stand on the side, she's got
Betty Davis eyes. Remix with Bob Dylan. Oh, this video is painfully 80s. At the Bonfire SXM, we'll tweet it out. I mean, the Flock of Seagulls haircut?
She's looking at a teacher you'd want to fuck.
Yes. Can I tell you this right? Oh my God. Can I tell you this right now? Turn me around.
I bet she looks good now still, though.
Yeah. Jay, can I tell you something?
What's up, buddy?
Turning me around on those.
Come up, Blue.
I'm forgetting about getting those chips to 142.
Turn it up for the chorus.
Kind of forgot that I had to do ice, the back bar for side work. When she snows you, hop your feet with the crow. Cold Eyes, how you feeling about this? You into it?
She's precocious.
You never liked this song? What's up?
Just what it takes to make a pro match.
Yeah, see?
Feels so good.
Think she's a spy. She's got Charles Manson eyes.
You never liked this song at all?
My favorite part about that drop is it always makes Jacob laugh.
They overplayed it a lot, and it was so overplayed you couldn't escape it.
Doesn't matter, not now, it's not.
No, I still
sorry you were in high school in 1982.
Yeah. Well, maybe if you weren't a time traveler.
But close.
Yeah. Oh, cool, I didn't know you were working your way through your first marriage in 1982. Driving to the factory all the time.
I apologize, I didn't realize that was you. You wrecked your Camaro.
Was that when you came back from Iran? I don't know. I was trying to think of a conflict. I don't think there was actually anything going on.
Yeah, sure. First Desert Storm, buddy.
91. That was 91. Grenada, thank you. Yeah, you were in this. You were in the fucking guerrilla territories dropping off guns for drugs.
This is when you were working in Blackwater, man.
Shout out to Smoked Honey for sending these pens.
But you're back on this song.
Oh, I'm way back.
Hang on, wait. It's the best part.
Just please, yeah.
I mean, she's like a champion.
All right.
Oh, those ugly moves. I bet she was a lesbian. Was she a lesbian, Christine? Look it up. Use your lesbo dar.
Dyke dar?
Use your dyke dar.
Boy. That. She goes, oh, we got one coming in.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That's a muff muncher for sure.
She goes, oh, we got a softball catcher coming in quick. Boing. Boing.
These are all good songs. You just let the playlist go.
As someone who's bisexual, do you feel like you have a better gaydar than...
I feel like I can always spot it.
You feel like you can spot it all the time?
Yeah. I'm like, that's a lesbian.
I love
that's
when 80s... I love the 80s pop music. Because it was all the same kind of music.
It was all... But... Do some coke to this music.
But... The lyrics are much darker than the songs would ever.
It's like, have you ever talked
she's
shit straight. To a dog, but use that tone where you go, "You're a fucking asshole. You're a fucking asshole."
That's what's happening.
Yeah, and then when you do this, like, "She's gonna die."
No, this song's about his chick's going away. He calls another girl over to fuck. Then he boots her out and tells her to stop bitching about it.
Oh yeah,
that's literally.
And he looks like a guy that would do it. He looks like a guy that'd do that.
Look, we're finally doing our DJing.
You're listening to live good songs that have shitty points.
Like he says, I like my girls a little bit older. I was like, good job.
Who said that?
He said that's a lie. I like my girls a little bit older.
He looks like he's 13. At the Bonfire SXM, we'll tweet it out. I had that hair in fucking fifth grade. That was my fifth grade haircut.
Everybody in the 80s was such a dork.
Yeah. It looks like the lead singer of The Outfield. It looks like if he smiled, his mouth would break.
Yeah.
Like it would rip skin.
It to happen again.
It looks like his mouth is just a little fucking donut hole.
He goes, please stop making me laugh.
He goes, stop. Ow. Oh. Ow.
Did you hear the story about sand?
That hurt big time.
That hurt big time. The tip just got me, Odell. The tip
just got me, Odell. Oh, that got me good.
Yeah. He's on the tour bus. He has to kick Sam Kennison off. He's like, please stop. Please stop. Oh, air drumming, huh? When are we going to line up this fucking rubber match of you and Silver?
On the drum off?
Yeah, we have to do it. Is it the next live show or do we skip a live show like a pay-per-view?
We skip a live.
So maybe...
Wait, here it is. As you're leaving, please won't you close the door? And don't forget what I told you. Just cause you're a dick don't mean I'm wrong. Another shoulder to cry upon. Oh, fuck off, bitch. Thanks for letting me drop a batch on your chest. Can you shut the door on your way out?
He might as well put the lyric in there. Don't let the door hit you where the good Lord split you.
That's what he says.
Yeah. That's badass.
I mean, what a hunk of piece of shit.
Yeah,
I ain't got many friends left to talk to, nowhere to run when I'm in trouble. You know I'd do anything for you. Stay the night, but keep it undercover.
It's great.
I just want to use your love tonight.
No, that's it. As you're leaving, please would you close the door and don't forget what I told you. Just because you're right, it don't mean I'm wrong. Another shoulder to cry upon. Oh, I love it. Fuck off and stop whimpering.
Leave.
I told you it was just tonight, you idiot.
Go all the way down. Who wrote the song? Josh. John Frederick Speaks.
Gary Soder.
Whoa. There should be some checks somewhere for that.
Interesting.
I should be getting some sort of royalties.
Guys, I think I quit.
Guys, I think I just found out that I get to buy that cabin in Colorado I wanted.
Fuck off.
Your survival cabin that we're making our way to in the apocalypse. And just like that, we're back, everybody.
Welcome back to Staying on Point Bonfire. It only happens on the Lost Apes.
What can I tell you? The world's different. Lou Witzke has been bit by a zombie after being six-shooter Lou. Jacob, specializing in knives, has become intel for the group. Christine, also known as Flag Girl, head of security. Bo and Tom E. Hawk, well, they're just leading. They will be.
What are the best post-apocalyptic music videos? They're always pretty bad.
California Love?
That's a pretty good one.
It's a great one.
That's a pretty good post-apocalyptic video.
What's good. Another?
Bon Jovi Runaway might be the worst of as far as post-apocalyptic.
Yeah.
It's so ridiculous looking.
Well, do that one. I haven't seen it.
It's the 80s of post-apocalyptic. By the way, this was so great.
How cool would it have been to be...
Runaway, Bon Jovi. This was Tupac. Great. We talked to David Bryan.
Yeah. Gabby's dad.
Gabby's dad outside the thing. It still bothers him. This is so great. This is great information, by the way. I always thought the girl in the Runaway video, smoking hot, and then at the end, gets smoking hotterer.
Mm-hmm.
He still is upset. All that money we spent, they sent us some fat chick.
Dude, that's so funny.
The best.
That's great. That's the best. So great.
I don't know where she's at in the world now. I hope she's killed herself or she's not a fan of this.
Californication? That's not a post-apocalyptic video.
No.
Quit trying to shoehorn in your California rock.
Is it Bon Jovi Runaway, dummy?
No.
Stop trying to get me.
Stop trying to see Flea
in pants.
California Love, though. What's so crazy about that is if you're Tupac, you get out of jail and then you just get to film a fun post-apocalyptic video.
That's where
he's got all those hundreds.
And he's on the desert. And could you put this? Shoulder pads made of radial tires.
Please. I mean, it's so fun. That'd be so fun just to, you know, that's like a 2-day shoot. Just dressed up. Singing the same song over and over. It's already done, so he's got to lip sync it.
It is something, though, about filming a video. This, it looks so awesome when it's done.
Yeah.
But, you know, you're doing a TV show right now. A lot of things feel silly when you're doing them.
I'll tell you this, man.
Tupac being dressed like that at craft services looks like an asshole.
Well, it's also like him trying to yell gangster shit like on the phone with a lawyer, and he's dressed like he fucking uses water for gas. and a guy's got spiderweb eye makeup on his thing, and Dre's like, yo, tell that bitch-ass motherfucker he can't come in here. And you're like, sorry, your post-apocalyptic sand eye patch is ready to put on.
Yeah.
And they're like this, and cut, I'm sorry, we gotta strike that light up there, can we do that? The one thing that...
The shin guard's hurting.
Yeah, you've been on, I mean, we've both done enough stuff that it's, TV can kind of be ruined, because even when you're watching a conversation between two people, you're like, alright, that's a different camera angle, that's a different camera angle, that's a different camera angle. So they had to do that setup so many different times that you're like, oh, this must be exhausting to make this show.
I'll tell you what's really funny is I saw some footage that got released today of Joaquin Phoenix playing the Joker.
Yeah.
And he argues with a clown. He's not like in Joker costume. It's his origin story.
Yeah, I was almost playing like a small thing in it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, just like a guy in a TV studio that sees...
That's awesome. He takes the nose off the clown and like chucks down the street. But as I'm watching the scene, it's somebody just filmed it with like an iPhone.
Yeah.
In Harlem, seeing it get filmed. And man, I was just... It made me laugh watching it going, you know what? Yeah, I'm a good actor, I guess.
You are. You're a great actor.
I'm as good as whatever this is. This is just... It's going to look so different. When the guy like grabs his like shirt or something... Yeah. Did you watch it?
No, I didn't watch the clip.
The guy grabs his shirt. It just looks so like... You're like, this is shitty. Like,
yeah, but
not that it's shitty. It's just that it's not any... The things I'd worry, I'm like, that doesn't look real. Or that doesn't look kind of normal. Like, it's...
But you've been around, when you're around like a good actor, you're like, oh fuck, this person knows how to do it.
Oh yeah, no, especially like, if someone turns on the drama, like the sad or the
crazy.
The sad or the angry.
I watched Damian Lewis do the final scene that I have with him at the end of season 3.
Is that when the aliens give you back?
That's when the aliens give me back.
But they've already done all the damage.
No, my bones are animanium. Okay. And this is, how they bridge together the X-Men universe and Billions.
I wish we should do a thing. We got to find shows. Like all the shows that Dan has been
a part of?
Away that I had used guest host.
Oh, yeah.
And put together what I keep saying the storyline is that Dan's filming today.
I would love that. I would love to see that.
I've had you getting full penetration gang raped.
Yeah, there's ones where...
A lot of space travel, intergalactic shit.
I killed Axe, I think you said one time. So that's a big one.
Killed Axe.
That's pretty big. But talking about being in a room with like a really awesome actor, watching him do... that scene, like his part of the scene, you're like, oh fuck, oh fuck, like this guy's so good, because he's just, he's like doing it in a different way, but it still feels real.
Yeah.
So it's all like, there was a time he did it, like where there was one part, it's the same exact sentences, but at some, you know, obviously this is kind of an idiotic explanation of acting, but he's like the same sentences, and at one point he's like yelling it at me, and I'm like, fuck, this guy's pissed, and I know it's fake. I'm standing there and I'm like, I know it's Damien, it's not really Bobby Axelrod, but I'm like, fuck, he's mad. And then they like do it immediately.
You talk about this in therapy, because this sounds like your father. He goes, I know he's acting, but I don't.
No. The whole point is that they make it so believable that the next take he does, he was like upset, like bummed out with me,
right?
Like, fuck man, like you let me down.
Same lines,
and it felt like two completely different things. Yeah. It was like one was like, oh fuck, this dude's furious at me, and then there's one where it's like, I am, it was the fuck you, I'm gonna kill you, into I'm not mad, I'm disappointed, and you're like, like in the second one, and I was like legitimately,
and both times you just had to go, what
you've been drinking Colombian decaffeinated,
what?
You son of a bitch.
Look at this girl. This is the girl from Bon Jovi Runaway. I thought she was so hot.
This is a post-apocalyptic?
Oh, buddy. Wait till you see how they're dressed. Oh. It's post-apocalyptic, all right.
Oh, dude, she's...
And she's the fire starter.
She's cute.
She's really cute.
Yeah.
That's post-apocalyptic right there, Dan. I don't know if you see that they have things tied around their biceps.
Yeah, that's tassels, though. That's the 80s. No, 80s were tassel-heavy.
That means that the bomb is going off.
That means, oh.
Look at the smashed stuff in the background.
That looks like a stage set. All right,
Dan, fine. It's not post-apocalyptic.
That looks like a stage set from the 90s.
Everything you've seen post-apocalyptic is going to be a stage set. There hasn't been an apocalypse.
Not Thunderdome. I'm saying this looks like a live concert.
Bon Jovi was so cool.
I think I just missed them.
You definitely missed their What Would Be Cool to a Kid.
Yeah.
For sure. That's our age gap.
That's it.
Completely.
Yes, it is. It's Bon Jovi. We call it the Bon Jovi gap.
Because to a kid, they were cool as shit.
Yeah.
Two albums, and then you can go backwards too.
Yeah.
But New Jersey, after New Jersey, like you lost the teenagers.
Yeah, sure. It was Colorado. It was like... Yeah.
Not bad songs.
Not bad songs at all.
They became adult contemporary music when they were...
This was music for, like, babysitters. Like, my babysitter had, like, liked Bon Jovi and also Guns N' Roses.
Yeah.
And Metallica and NWA. It was, like, all over the place.
And you
she
like,
was a troubled girl.
You were a Bruce Hornsby guy.
I was a Steve Winwood, Jimmy Buffett, Harry Chapin, James Taylor fellow myself.
Look at that.
Softer listening.
Did anybody give a shit about Bruce Springsteen where you were from?
Nope.
That's the same thing, like, where I'm from, like... Bon Jovi, Bruce Springsteen, and so it's very East Coast. So everyone from East Coast,
New Jersey,
them,
and you had a long term crush on a guy from New Jersey. That's why you're asking questions. Is Billy Joel a thing? I don't know. How about the Eagles, the Giants?
I feel like where I'm from, like Tom Petty was revered more than Bruce Springsteen.
I mean, I knew more Tom Petty than I did Springsteen.
Yeah, me
up.
Too.
I did. Well, I guess I knew
Springsteen.
I didn't know anybody in my life that was super into Bruce Springsteen.
Me neither.
But Bruce Springsteen was contemporary music when I was a kid still.
Yeah, Bruce Springsteen to me was like...
I remember Born to Run coming out, or not Born to Run.
Born in the USA?
Born in the USA coming out, yeah.
But it was, to me, Born in the USA, I learned Springsteen was popular through Charles in Charge. Because there's this thing where they're like, we got Springsteen tickets, and I was like, those must be pretty important. And
I went
like,
over to Charles, I went over to Scott to ask him if he got the new Bruce Springsteen album. He responded by throwing hot tea in my face.
Goddamn, that was fucking funny.
I've watched it on the road myself several times. Or showing
she's
it to
so
people.
Hot.
She's so hot.
What is he talking about?
She's a fat pig to him.
Jesus.
She looks like a young B.D. Wong.
Well, that's right? Not necessarily true.
No, but like a hot way.
Oh.
This is not post-apocalyptic. This is so fucking crusty.
It's post-apocalyptic.
They have to look back at our shit, though. Like, mumble rap, when we're older. Or what's ours? Mine was, like, late 90s. Like, I'm trying to think of my teenage years. What was, like...
Is Running with the Night post-apocalyptic? Lionel Richie?
Oh, I thought you were talking about Pat Benatar.
No. Does she do a post-apocalyptic one?
Yeah, she does.
You're right. Love is a battlefield.
That's not post-apocalyptic. No, it's not post-apocalyptic. That's about a girl running away, dressing like a hooker, and then a pimp approaches her, and it's one of the funniest things ever. in a video in my life. I think we've done this on the show. I know the whole choreography if you gave me one pass at it.
Okay, go to Pat Benatar. Stop. Just go to Pat Benatar.
When she goes...
Oh, no. Pat Benatar, what is it?
When she goes... To the pimp, she gets mad at the pimp.
What song?
He makes a stupid face with his gold tooth, and then she backs up into a line of strangers, and then starts. Best part of the song, the dance breakdown.
You think you get one go at this? You can get it. We have cameras here. I mean, they're rock. They're locked. Wait, ready to
back
go.
Up.
Yeah.
Here we go.
I mean, this is iconic. Yeah. There's one thing left.
That face
pimps.
Goes, no way, they are dancing at me.
No. Who told them to dance like this? Damn it. My whores are turning against me using choreograph.
You can catch Benatar now at a Six Flags.
Yeah.
That's my sure first. It was my first big concert.
Dan.
Look, he's doing it. Oh, my God.
Jay's on it. Oh, there's a drop. There's a drop.
Start it from the top.
I knew I had to.
Start it from the top. And five and six and seven and Christine. Christine, where the hell is my musical?
I do not like dancing. That guy's great. Stop dancing. I'll dance against you. Now you're dancing against me. Now we are both dancing.
Yeah, by the way, she was just mad at this pimp. Now she's like, nah, if you got moves, I'll work with you,
she
I
goes,
guess.
Ooh, I didn't know this guy's got fucking.
What do I give you? 80%? Cool.
All right, yeah. She goes, no hitting, though.
Just, all right, light hitting. Just not the face.
Legs. All Charlie right. horses over.
Just left side of the face.
Charlie horses.
Okay, don't set me on fire.
Okay, no knives.
From the knees up.
Let me make sure you don't have knives.
You making concessions?
Just dance negotiating with a pimp?
50-50.
Okay.
Okay, 80-20. Okay.
Condom on everyone.
20-80. I understand.
20-80. Yes, daddy.
Yes, daddy. Just, he goes, but you can't. You can't leave your. You can't put your brand on my ass, though. Okay, quick one.
Dance negotiating with a pimp is so goddamn funny. Okay, so you don't call me bitch. No, you do call me bitch.
Goes, I just don't want to be one of your hoes. I want to be your main hoe. Just one of the regular old hoes?
Okay.
I can deal with that for a little bit. But there's room for promotion, right?
Okay.
You're not hiring for promotion. Okay, gotcha.
Can I be bottom bitch? No bottom bitch. Got it. That's fair.
Understood.
I am
Understood. I do have one hard line, though, and I don't want to work on Sundays. Sundays is your busy season? Okay, gotcha. Okay. All right. You know what? I'll be there Sunday.
That's fair.
I'll be there. Meet me there early?
Yeah.
Work a double?
Okay. I'll work double.
What is the personality of the hooker?
Oh, dude, I legitimately thought Jacob was talking.
What is the personality?
God damn, those drops are perfectly put in. That
I was thinking about Invincible, Pat Benatar is Apocalypse.
If that's post-apocalypse, that bums me out, because when I think of that song, I think of one thing only, and that's Binks getting his motherfucking bike back.
Billy Jean.
He just wants his scooter back.
Mm-hmm.
You took his scooter,
yeah,
and you fucked it up,
mm-hmm.
and then now and then she had to shoot a guy.
Yeah. Fair is fair.
Fair is fair. Fair is fair.
Yeah. Yeah.
Great movie, though.
What?
So stupid. Legend of Billie Jean? Come on.
Never saw
Come
it.
On!
Sorry, dude.
Well, if you want to not talk about Legend of Billie Jean...
Billie Jean's maybe a song by Michael Jackson.
But see a little comedy, I guess you can go catch Dan Soder in Minneapolis at Acme Comedy Club.
Dude.
That's this weekend. Yeah!
Dude, I know we have to get going. I was trying to order posters to sell tonight, so I won't have them tonight at the show, but I'll have them Friday. This fucking, that Midwestern niceness shit is just, it's bullshit.
Why do you say that?
Because they have the voice, or they're like, hi, how are ya? And I tried ordering posters, and then the lady just turned super fucking mean, where I was like, okay, well, I need like a, you know, 8.5 by 14. She goes, does it bleed? I was like, I don't know what that means. I can send you the file. And she's like, okay, well, we'll work it up. And then I sent it, and she goes, it bleeds. So now we need to do a whole different thing. And I was like, all right, you don't need to speak to me like that. And she's like, well, we need to do a whole different, it's a whole different thing. And I was like, cancel the order. Cancel the fucking order. Fuck you. I'm not fucking, I didn't say fuck you, but I was like, cancel the order.
Did you give any money?
Nope. And I was like, they're like, okay, fine, all right.
What place did you call? So we could, maybe our fans will, like, you know, go protest.
You know what I don't do? Snitch.
Like, everything bleeds. That's your one rule. I know
fucking
that.
Fucking snitches
I know.
Get stitches with hatchets.
Well, that's, I why, saw that tweet, that's why I got physical with you and Pete Tomic yesterday.
Yeah, you just dominated us.
You just dominated us.
Big J. Oakerson going to be in Minneapolis. He's going to be at Comics
World. Wait, I didn't even say you're going to be at the Funny Bone in Omaha.
Sorry, dude.
That's the next weekend, the 27th through the 29th, everyone. Yeah. Still this month. Have some fun with Dan Soder. If you want to get tickets for that and all of his tour dates, you can go to dansoder.com.
I'm so sorry for rudely interrupting. Big J is going to be at the Comics in Mohegan Sun tonight through Saturday. That's the 20th through the 22nd. With Mike Fenoich. So go hang out, have some, you know, do some gambling, have some dinner. See Big J and Mike Fenoich. And then Calgary, Alberta, Canada, home of Stampede Wrestling and the Stampede. Go to Yuck Yucks in Calgary to see Jay September 28th and the 29th. Tickets for all those shows at BigJComedy.com. Also, subscribe to the Best of the Bonfire. It's the podcast. It's actually a Friday show that we air, but now it's available as a podcast. You can download and subscribe on Apple Podcasts and wherever you download podcasts from. Follow us at the Bonfire SXM, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. We love you, motherfuckers.
We love you so hard.
So fucking much.
The hardest.
Come here, let me give you a kiss.
Catch you next week live.
Yeah, live. I'll be here Monday. I don't know if I'm going to be here Tuesday.
You don't have to announce it to them yet.
I'm sorry.
Let it be a whole thing.
I just want you guys.
You're going to be here Monday, right?
I just want you to prepare.
You want some belly kisses?
Yeah. Hey, a fan got you these socks.
Really?
Yeah.
Are they for me?
Yeah. I got my own pair.
I don't think they are for me. I feel like they are for you.
He gave me two pairs and he goes, you keep one and give one to Jay. Why would I bring my pair in? That makes no sense.
I don't know what to say.
Say thank you. He's from Sacramento. They're Cobra Kai socks.
Thank you from Sacramento.
Thank you, guy from Sacramento. I don't even think he gave his name. If he did, I was high. I apologize.
Oh.
Dude.
We love you guys. We'll catch you next week on the Bonfire. Crackle, crackle.
Crackle, crackle.
Ciao, baby.